Based in the magnificent Ardennes countryside, Spa hosted its first Grand Prix back in 1925. This historic track is loved by drivers and fans alike. So it's welcome to the Belgian Grand Prix. Spa-Francorchamps then, a historic 19-corner circuit with a lap distance of 4.35 miles. There's over 100 metres of elevation change here, and with long stretches of the lap spent flat out, a good top speed will be vital for success. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today. But I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Sebastian Vettel will start on pole. Fantastic qualifying from the multiple world champion. And Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Bottas, Charles Leclerc and Albon, Magnussen, Perez, Sainz and Lance Stroll, Ricciardo, Norris, Esteban Ocon and Grosjean, Kvyat, Gasly, Nicholas Latifi and George Russell, Raikkonen and Antonio Giovinazzi starts from the back of the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
To see at the start. Well done. DRS is now enabled. Is dropping back. We're seeing a gap form. We'll be right back. race move. We'll be right back. job. Nice overtake. Strategy is available on the MFD. Got that confirmed. Has started to drop back. There's a gap beginning to form. 5.7 seconds. We're leading our teammate by 12.3 seconds. You're going to start losing some tire grip around now. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. VSC deployed. The virtual safety car has been deployed. We need to keep a positive delta here. Slow down, maintain a positive delta. Release, release. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green. We'll be doing one more stop today. One stop left in our strategy. Top 10 now. Keep it up. To the car in front is 2.0 seconds. Caution, caution, the virtual safety car is out. Reduce speed and maintain a positive delta. Drop your speed, our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Gap to teammate behind is 2.7 seconds. Albon is in the pits. Carlos is in the pits. Bottas is leading the race. Seconds. Verstappen has just put up the fastest lap of the race so far. Bottas is behind you. Okay, the gap behind is 1.0 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. The time last lap was a 2:03.9. job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. Front is 2.7 seconds. Is increasing by a few tenths per lap. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Confirmed. is 3.6 seconds. Front is 4.0 seconds. approaching the pit window, you'll be on the softs. We're leading our teammate by 36.3 seconds. Clear. Push now, we're boxing this lap. stands out in front. Exit, exit now. Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tires. The car ahead is 18.2 seconds. You have P5, P5. Bottas is ahead of you. Gap to car in front is 18.2 seconds. They're on old mediums. Leclerc is behind you. Our gap behind is 1.3 seconds. They're on old mediums. The gap to the leader is 29.5 seconds. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. 12 laps to go. Pulling out a second lap on the car behind. said is 16.3 seconds. Bottas ahead. Our gap to the car in front is 16.3 seconds. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 13 laps old. The time last lap was a 1 minute 50.7. Work. That's a new fastest lap of the race. Has the lead. To the car ahead is 12.3 seconds. was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Gap to teammate behind is 31.3 seconds. Front is 9.2 seconds. Five laps of fuel remaining. Catching the car ahead, but be aware that these tyres need to last till the end of the race. 4 laps of fuel remaining. We're increasing our gap on the car behind by around a second a lap. Bottas is ahead of you. Okay, gap ahead is 6.4 seconds. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 20 laps old. The time last lap was a 1:49.5. 1.2 seconds advantage per lap. It's a new fastest lap of the race. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. Front is 4.8 seconds. Fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. We're leading our teammate by 43.7 seconds. Conditions look stable at the moment. No rain currently expected. Dry seem like the fastest tyre at the moment. We've only got 2 laps of fuel left. Hamilton's out in front. This is your final lap of the race. The end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
The Mercedes team pulled out a fantastic performance today. They should be proud. Ant, talk to me. What do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
I think for driver of the day, I'd probably pick Lando Norris. He lived up to every inch of his reputation today, and I think he'll be going home, quite rightly, a bit proud of himself.
Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.